Welcome everyone to my channel Osmosis. Today we are going to start the last but not the least part of our chapter, that is Nelson Mandela. So at the end of this video, I have given you question answers again, because in the first video the question answers might not have been very clear. So let's start our chapter. In life, every man has twin obligations. Obligations to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children. And he has obligations to his people, his community, his country. In a civil and human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his inclinations and abilities. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. In South Africa, a man who has tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother and father, and a husband. Every man has two duties or obligations, one towards his family and the other towards the society or his country at large. Man tries to fulfill both these duties according to their qualities and capabilities and nature. However, Mandela says, in South Africa, people were denied to perform these duties. If he tries to fulfill these duties towards society, he was punished or put behind the bars. As you have seen, Mandela was trying to place the society above his family, so he was thrown to the prison and was denied to fulfill his right as son, brother, father and a husband. I was born with a hunger to be free. I was born free, free in every way that I could know. Free to run in the fields near my mother's hut, free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village, free to roast meals under the stars and ride the broad back of slow-moving bulls. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or. During his childhood days, Mandela ran after transitory happiness. Transitory means short happiness, such as staying out at night, read what he pleased, or riding the bulls, run in the fields, swim in the stream, roast meals under starlight, etc. But his illusion or false notion was soon vanished, and he understood that the scope of freedom was far more wider than that. He understood that all citizens' freedom was curtailed. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself, and the transitory freedom of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased, and go where I choose. Later, as a young man of Johannesburg, I yearned for basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not be obstructed in a lawful life. Mandela grew to be a boy. He understood his conception of freedom was an illusion or wrong idea. At first, as a student, he wanted his freedom. Later, as a young man of Johannesburg, he wanted to marry, have family, to do his duty in a lawful way. But then I slowly saw that not only was I free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life. that transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, that drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal, that turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home, that forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is indivisible. The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. The chains on all of my family were the chains on. Gradually, Mandela realized not only he or his family members, but the whole race was suffering from the same problem. Their freedom had been curtailed or taken away by the whites. Children, you just tell me one thing. If you don't get something, don't you become rebellious? Similar is the matter, and our freedom movement is also the burning example of it. When Mandela understood that their freedom was curtailed very mercilessly by the whites, he longed for it more and more, and it became his obsession. The young, frightened man was transformed into bold one. A law-abiding attorney became a vagabond, or vagabond means without any home. He stood boldly against the white and was imprisoned for 30 years.
I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom, just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity.
According to Mandela, oppressed means the black, and the oppressor means the white, both must be liberated or freed from hatredness, narrow-mindedness and prejudice. Those who takes away others' freedom are also not free. Both oppressor and the oppressed lost their humanity, good values. Both are sailing in the same boat. So with that, we have concluded our chapter. Please subscribe and see the question answers at the end. Thank you all. Please take a screenshot of the same.